previous episode of Life is Strange.
Get that gun away from me, psycho! No!
Whoa. What the fuck?
But he could be talking about photography.
Or have you done something wrong? Talk to me.
Hey, Victoria.
What do you want, Max?
I see everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand?
Is my mic
what
still
I'm
working
saying?
Or did it reset itself again?
For reals, Warren. This is between you and me.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
Hey! Leave him alone!
Okay,
Max?
Good.
Chloe?
It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Welcome home, Max.
That's Rachel Amber. Her missing person posters are all over Blackwell.
6 months ago, she just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me. Something happened to her.
Wait! Is that grass? Tell me the truth. That's an order.
I didn't black out. I had another vision. The town is going to get wiped out by a tornado.
Max, tell me everything.
Being a superhero is dirty work. I need a shower. The Max Caulfield Photo Memorial Wall.
48,000 seats, please.
Even with all this crazy shit going on, it is so cool having Chloe back in my life again. Like no time has passed. I can't keep my eyes open, but I know there's a scientific answer. Warren is blowing up my inbox now. As long as he helps me figure this out. This is so insane, it sounds logical to me. This wormhole thing makes total sense, but doesn't explain how I can do what no scientist ever has. I would say this is some crazy shit, but now I'm not so certain. Should I sign? And I thought I was into Halloween. Dana is not messing around here.
I'm gonna not water the plant today because I remember I watered it both episodes and then in episode 3 it was dead, so.
Now I have to wonder if any of these films are based on a true story. Uh-oh. I wonder if I'll ever wear a watch again. Okay, Max, let's hit the showers now.
Gordon, seriously? Do not forget I need those papers before tonight. Like, now. Thanks, Sherry.
Yeah, of course, Victoria. I'll get the tests and papers to you this afternoon. I am so on it, consider it done. Ow!
Poor Alyssa, oh my gosh.
Alyssa, can you stand over there?
Okay, Max, if that makes you happy. Wow, now that was close. Thank you, Max.
Nice atmospheric shot. Needs dusting. What's happening, Dana? Everything cool between you and Juliet?
Oh, yeah. Thanks again for releasing me from her captivity. By the way, the best and biggest news of the day is that Trevor asked me to the Halloween shindig.
That's awesome, Dana.
At least we're showing our faces together in public. So you absolutely should go with us. Borrow one of my outfits and come as a cute geek couple with your bitch, Warren.
I'm not big on cosplay.
Don't let life pass you by, Max. So, are you coming to the party or not?
Why the fuck not? If I hate it, I can always go back to my room.
That's the spirit, Max. After this, you'll be ready for a rave.
It does sound like fun. Now I have to go contemplate my party future. That is so damn cute how much Dana is into this Halloween party. Could be fun. Glad I'm not the only lonely nerd around here. Thanks for the warning. Hey, Kate. How are you doing?
I'm here. Thanks again for standing up for me yesterday. I needed that.
Anytime. That guy has issues.
Doesn't everybody here? By the way, Max, do you still have my copy of the October Country?
Oh, yes, of course. It's great so far. I didn't realize Bradbury was such a poet.
Can you please bring it back to my room this morning? I just need to take some notes for class.
Absolutely. I'll bring it by later.
What's up, Kate?
School.
That's it? That video of you clubbing didn't look like homework.
Victoria, that wasn't me.
Oh my god, right.
Don't be shy. I think it's awesome you set a tongue record on video.
You're going to be sorry someday.
Oh, boo-hoo. I'm sorry you're a viral slut. I'm sure she had fun.
Looks like it.
I know Nathan hooked her up. And you know he has the good shit.
Preach it, sister.
Yup, I still have goddamn paint all over my face. Good thing my faithful minions took their sweet time bringing me a towel.
We ran all the way-
Give it a rest, Taylor. Now I know if I'm in an accident, I won't rely on you or Courtney for help. You can hang out with Kate. Or Max.
She's a weirdo with that dumb camera.
I hate that I'm so quirky crap. Anyway, let's leave the link to Kate's video so everybody gets a chance to see her in action.
You are such an evil biatch. I love it.
I better get dressed and go give back Kate's book. Even if I can stop one person from watching it, it's worth it. Hey, Brooke.
Oh, hi, Max.
Did you see the freak snowfall yesterday?
I was riveted by that weird snow flurry yesterday.
I can't tell if you're being serious or not. Since I'm a science noob, I was wondering if you could explain it.
I'm serious. Even meteorologists can't explain that snow. I bet Warren can. Did you talk to him yet?
No, not at all. He's my friend, not my mother.
True. And Warren really loves to talk meteorology with me, since I'm one of the few who can talk back. Talk to you later, Max.
Maybe I'll just put on a shirt and jeans. Hey, Einstein had the same exact suit for every day of the week, and he couldn't even rewind time. Of course she just spilled soda on Kate's book. I better fix this fast. Kate needs the book, and I don't want to add to her list of problems. Be gone, foul soft drink. Aha, you sneaky book. You're mine. Now I can finally take this back to Kate before I'm late. As if I have to worry about being late anymore. I do have all the time in the world now. Now I'm getting anonymous threats? It never ends. This has to be from Nathan. But it could be anybody. I better be doubly careful around here, or I could be in serious danger. If I'm not already.
Kate? You in there?
Yes, I'm here. Come in, Max.
Um,
Hey, Kate, I brought your book.
Max, why did you step in between David and me yesterday?
I hate bullies. David Madsen should know better.
I was hoping he would. But it's nice to see that you care about me.
Kate, I actually do care. So, what's the story with you and David?
Well, he's a total paranoid ass. He thinks I'm part of the Vortex Club. Yeah, right.
Why does he think that?
Because he saw the video. You know how humiliating this is for me?
I know this sucks, Kate, but tell me about the video and maybe I can help.
Basically, I went to one Vortex Club party and ended up making out with a bunch of people. And I have no memory of it.
It doesn't sound like you. I can't see you partying with Victoria.
I didn't.
You have to tell me more than that. What happened at the party? Did you drink?
I swear to God, I had one sip of red wine, and then I drank water.
Not enough to get wasted, is it?
I don't get wasted. Ever. I take a sip at church, and I don't end up on a viral video, okay?
Did somebody drug you?
I remember getting sick and dizzy.
Go on.
Then Nathan Prescott said he would take me to the hospital.
Nathan Prescott? Oh, shit.
He was being nice for a change when he offered to help me.
He's the opposite of nice. What next?
All I recall is driving for a long time. Then I woke up in a room. I thought it was a hospital because it was so white and bright.
Go on. I'm listening.
Somebody was talking to me in a soft voice. I thought it was a doctor until I heard Nathan and felt a sharp sting in my neck. And? That's all I remember. I don't know what happened. I woke up outside my dorm room the next day. I didn't have any marks or bruises, but I felt gross.
So, who took the video of you at the party?
I have no idea. Probably Victoria. She was there being her mean self.
Jesus, Kate. I'm sorry. This is serious shit.
How do I get a viral video taken down? I know it's already spreading. What if my church sees that? I need to know what to do.
Kate, we'll figure it out. I'll check back later, okay?
Thanks, Max. You can put my book here near my bag.
Kate even makes notes in her Bible. My parents never once took me to church. I had nothing to rebel against. I don't know what to believe now. Damn, it's the all-American zombie family. It's way too emo in here. Kate isn't that gloomy. Until lately. Ouch. She left out Hamnation. That is the cutest bunny ever. I bet Kate is a good mommy. Hey, I'm trying to use my powers for good. I had no idea that Kate ever hung out with Alyssa and Stella. Kate really has a doting father. Kate's room is usually immaculate. For her, this must be a pigsty.
Almost forgot what Kate looks like when she smiles.
Never realized before how ominous this
Maybe Kate has a split personality. Church girl by day, party monster by night. Kate used to play the violin every morning. She stopped last week. Why did she cover up the mirror? She can't look at herself?
So, Max, can I ask you a question? And please be honest.
Absolutely, Kate. Anything.
I need to find out if Nathan Prescott helped me or hurt me after that party. Should I go to the police?
If you do that, they won't believe you. You're on video grabbing at all those guys, and they'll use that against you. Bad.
But I know I was drugged.
That's what you have to prove, not them. I'm just telling you how the cops in school will look at this. The video doesn't exactly back you up.
You make me feel so hopeless.
No, Kate. I just don't want you to get hurt anymore.
That seems impossible at this point. So that's your answer?
I think we should wait. There are other things going on that might help you.
But not right now. So I can walk down the halls with people calling me a viral slut. Thanks, Max.
Poor Kate.
Good job, Dr. Max. She didn't like what I had to say, but we need more proof of what happened.
Hello, Juliet.
Hey, Max! Did you check out Kate's hot video yet?
That's so not cool.
I didn't get wasted on camera and get busy with the Vortex Club.
Kate's not like that, and you know it.
Really? Check her out and tell me what she's like.
Do you believe everything you see? Like Zachary sexting Dana?
Touché. Now I feel like an ass. Thanks for finding out the truth yesterday.
What about Zachary? Did you let him off the hook?
When he acts like a worm, I let him dangle.
Glad to see you're back in action.
You have a good heart, Max. And I won't watch Kate's video anymore. Or pass it on.
That's the spirit. Thanks, Juliet.
Sure. Talk to you later.
Really, Max?
Oh, fine.
Go away! People are sleeping!
Clearly not a morning person. Samuel truly is a weirdo. But he is great at cleaning up. Paint job looks great. Samuel knows his color schemes. The birds are flocking around Samuel. Hey, Samuel. You're up early.
Oh, hello, young Max. I do love the early morning. Everything is so calm and quiet. And I can feel the animals waking up with me.
That's one thing I truly love about Arcadia Bay. It's all those cool animals in the forest.
The squirrels always come in the morning for food. I can hear them whisper. What animals do you see in the forest?
Don't laugh, but I saw a doe that seemed to be looking right at me, like it was trying to communicate.
Oh, that's your spirit animal. Nothing weird there except you saw yours. Could be a sign about your destiny. What do I know? My spirit animal is a squirrel.
So, what did you think about that freak snow shower yesterday?
Another message from the Earth to get our shit together. I will say that Samuel hasn't seen anything like that before.
I so don't want to get in the way of your morning ritual. See you later.
Of course you will.
I don't dislike Samuel, but I'm not totally sure what to think of him.
Samuel really should keep this locked. It's a waiting accident. And I've never seen Samuel wearing shades. And what's with this other crap? I can see that Samuel's concerned, but does he need a poster? How did Samuel get photos of Rachel posing?
That weird noise. I don't know what it is.
Release the Kraken. Come on, squirrels. Time for your 15 minutes of fame.
Oh, what the heck?
I better not get near the bench, or the squirrel won't take the food. Can't Blackwell have at least one no football zone? Yes! Another Pulitzer for the portfolio. Hi, Taylor.
Hi, Taylor. Just because you were nice to Victoria doesn't mean I have to be nice to you.
I don't want to fight with you or Victoria. Instead of smack talk, let's just talk. For once.
You're funny. Well, I'm not doing anything at the moment, so talk.
Why do you hang out with Victoria? She's pretty mean to you and Courtney.
And she's bossy, too. Look, you don't know her. I do. And she's one of the best friends you could have.
I guess I've had mean, bossy best friends, too. Better than having mean, bossy parents.
I would love it if my mom was mean or bossy instead of sick. But whatever. We've had our talk.
Hi, Taylor. I've heard that your mother was sick. I'm so sorry. What happened to her?
Well, if you do care, my mom had back surgery. Victoria was there for me. Like you are for Kate. I'm not about tearing people down, Max.
I know. That's why I wanted to talk.
I'm glad we did.
About it for this area. Not no one.
Max, come on over here.
Warren, what are you doing here?
Oh, nothing. Waiting for a call? I mean, I already took the call. Anyway, I wanted to rap about that action yesterday.
By the way, thank you for stepping in. You were pretty badass, Warren. I owe you.
Oh, yes, you do. I got knocked on my ass by that dick. I'm some personal superhero.
You're a real everyday hero. You stood up to a bully, and it was awesome.
Even though you left me with said bully and ran off with that girl, she's pretty punk rock. How do you know her?
An old friend, Chloe Price. We haven't seen each other in a while.
I bet you were glad to see her blast up in that truck like a rock star. Which begs the question, why is Nathan Prescott getting psycho on you?
I busted him in the bathroom yesterday with a gun. I was too scared to tell Principal Wells. Please, don't say anything. I'll give you more info later.
Weird fucking week. Like that bizarro snowfall yesterday? Speaking of dystopia, that drive-in is having a 70s Planet of the Apes marathon. Let's go ape!
Yes, that's exactly what I need. I love those old-school ape films.
Well, that was easier than I thought. Cool, I'll text you the info.
David talking to Nathan cannot be a good thing. This has something to do with Kate. Or Rachel.
The soundtrack.
Talk about going back in time. The diner looks exactly the same. Hello.
Oh, look at you. A fine example of youth. I bet you're a senior student.
Yes, I go to Blackwell Academy.
I could tell you're a wise young woman. I know all about Blackwell and this town.
I bet you have dirt on the Prescott family.
That whole family is dirty. They once done good things for Arcadia Bay. Those days are dead, like anything in their way.
I know somebody who's being threatened by a Prescott.
Then you be their guardian angel, because nothing gets in the way of that family, especially not the law. Hell, they own your school, Blackwell. Almost.
How long have you lived in Arcadia Bay?
1,000 years. I've gone through the same changes as the town.
What changes to the town?
Ones it takes a lifetime to see. There's a lot of beauty here, but a lot of darkness, too. Greedy bastards that ruin this town, put people out of work. Out of home. Like me.
I'm sorry. Have you ever lived outside of here?
Where the hell would I go? I hate the sun and love the mist. I might be homeless, but Arcadia Bay is still my home.
You must know Joyce Price from the Two Whales Diner.
She's fed me more than my own family. How's a daughter your age who's always in trouble? Married to a real prick.
His name is David Madsen.
He told me to get a job once, asshole. Not sure what Joyce sees in him, but he better treat her right.
I have to go now. Goodbye. Hello? Yes, I know some.
Then you.
You must.
She's.
Have you met Joyce's daughter?
Cute girl. Pissed off. I used to see her and her pretty friend, Rachel, around a lot.
Do you know anything about Rachel Amber? That missing girl?
I know she's missing. I know she hung out here a bit. Sometimes I'd see her walking, all by herself, deep in thought. Too damn young and pretty to look so worried.
Was she alone a lot or with friends?
Like I said, she seemed tight with Joyce's daughter. I thought I saw her with an older gent one time. Maybe her dad. That's a terrible thing for a parent to deal with. I pray the poor thing is all right. But you can't save everybody.
How long? What happened to you?
What didn't happen to me? Sometimes you start out in life turned around the wrong way. I married dumb, made mistakes, got cheated out of my savings, lost my home, and now I hang out here.
I'm sorry. Have you...
Where the...
I have to go now.
Come talk to me any old time you want, young lady.
The smell of breakfast and the sound of clanging silverware makes me feel 13 again. Oh man, I bet that's the same gum from when I was here last.
Ew.
That graffiti has been here forever. Gross. Thank you, redneck poet.
Coming up at noon, KBay 7 News will explore the mystery of yesterday's unusual snowfall on a warm and sunny late afternoon that confused and delighted Arcadia Bay residents. We'll be talking with Portland meteorologists in the area and look at some of your fun video reactions to the odd snow flurry. Who knows? Maybe Mother Nature was pranking us all. So stay tuned to KBay 7 News for the real story.
Hello, sir.
Hi, young lady. You look a little lost.
Just hungry and thinking about what to eat.
Now, that is a real problem at the Two Wells. I can never decide. Joyce's pumpkin pie or grilled mac and cheese?
How well do you know Joyce?
I know her delicious grub. Everybody at the station comes here. We take care of this place like it's our own kitchen. And Joyce, like she's our mother.
So, you know Chloe?
Sadly, we all know Chloe down at the station. Poor Joyce. Just heard she even just got busted with pot in her room.
Who told you that?
I didn't hear it on the police scanner. Joyce said the weed belonged to Chloe's friend, but I highly doubt that.
Joyce didn't tell you who?
She wouldn't. Afraid I'd go arrest somebody, as if I would. I just tell the loser to stay the hell away from Chloe, or else. Just kidding. Besides, David Madsen's watching over. Is she a friend of yours?
I know her.
Then you know she's a handful.
She can be, but she can also be a good friend who shows up when you need her.
Sounds like you're a good friend. I wish she would be a great daughter and not cause Joyce so much stress.
I guess you're friends with David Madsen.
I wouldn't use that word. We know each other. Why do you ask?
He kinda has a reputation at Blackwell.
I have respect for David. He served his country. He found his calling at Blackwell. At the station, we're happy David is exactly where he is. Not everybody can be a cop.
I have to go now. Enjoy your breakfast.
By the way, one thing I can tell you for certain is to stay away from that RV outside.
I usually stay away from sketchy parked vehicles.
Wise policy. The guy who lives in it, Frank, is pretty sketchy himself. That's all I can say for now. I should finish up my coffee and get to work.
Hello?
Pardon moi, but you're in my eyesight.
Isn't everything in here within eyesight?
I don't care for your tone. You sound like Joyce.
How does Joyce sound?
Bossy and smartass. Like you.
Joyce rules. I want to be exactly like her when I grow up.
Looks like you're on your way. I've been coming to this dive for 3 years, and Joyce gives me shit like it's going out of style.
That's how she rolls. That's why I worship her every move.
Good. I can't wait to see you flipping greasy bacon in a diner when you grow up. Exactly like Joyce. Now pardon me while I get back to my coffee.
He's a real piece of work.
Drool. Want everything.
Seriously? Come on.
And there she is. A lovely young woman. How are you doing, Max?
Hi, Joyce. It's nice to see you again. You look the same.
Like I'm still a waitress at Two Whales after all these years.
No, like you still look pretty.
Nice save, kid. You're still smart. But I wish you'd been here to help save Chloe. She got busted yesterday smoking out. again.
I know. Chloe told me that her stepfather hit her.
I am sorry that was your introduction to David. I hope you get to know him on your terms, not Chloe's. He's a good man, he just...
Yeah, I'm sure he is since you married him, but... Don't be so harsh on Chloe.
It's good you're here. I was hoping you could be a good influence in her life now.
I will be. Promise. I know things were hard for you and Chloe. I feel bad I didn't call. Now my folks are in Seattle and I'm all alone at Blackwell. It's my karma.
You did the right thing. You moved forward with your life. I did after William passed on. Chloe chose to stay angry.
Oh, excuse me.
Anyway, I hope we see more of you. Chloe needs an old friend again.
Joyce, I am so sorry about William. I have great memories of him.
I'm glad, Max. That was his gift to us. Wonderful memories. Even if Chloe doesn't understand yet.
Chloe understands. She just needs time. I know that sucks for you.
Oh, she hit all the phases. Expulsion, running away, drugs, bad boys, tattoos, piercings, blue hair. Now she's gotta rebel against her stepfather.
I see why,
Why? What did Chloe tell you?
Well, Chloe texted me that David slapped her yesterday.
He feels awful, and he will be punished. But Chloe does push David, and it's not fair. He paid his dues in a war. He does care about her, along with all the students at Blackwell.
He's just got a really messed up way of showing it.
That's no excuse to hit a girl. He's an adult.
I don't like it either, Max. David swore it would never happen again. He's true to his word. I just want us to be a family soon. I guess it's all about time.
I think you're right, Joyce.
So, now let's get down to the nitty-gritty. What do you want to eat?
I was dreaming about your bacon omelet.
Now finish your coffee.
One bacon omelet for the young lady, stat.
Nerd graffiti. Warren must have been here. I love the delicious... The only thing that's changed on the menu are the prices. This is like fourth dimensional deja vu. I keep going back in time.
Can I get some beer and bacon before I die?
This is a diner, not a bar.
No beer?
Looks like you had plenty. Stick with bacon.
This is like forging.
But what kind of dive is this?
Incoming!
I can hear your stomach rumbling from here, Max. Here, you'll love this.
I'm drooling like a baby.
Still can't believe you're a woman. When I look at pictures of Chloe, ugh. Speak of the devil.
Mom and Max, together again.
And Chloe, looking for a free meal. You put your whole damn college fund on your tab.
I'm treating Chloe for breakfast.
No, you're not. This is my treat. To you, for coming back to rescue my daughter.
Nobody needs to rescue me.
Unless you set your room on fire smoking out.
Oh God, here it comes. Didn't you and Sergeant Pepper already read me the riot act last night?
Call him David if you don't want to be lectured. You only get one damn slice of bacon a day.
You guys are still the same.
Another reason to blow this town. What is this shit on the jukebox? Now that that's out of the way. Let's talk about your superpower.
I don't have any explanation. And I can't explain why I saw that crazy fucking tornado.
Come on, that's just a daydream. I want proof you can rewind time.
This is all happening so fast.
We'll start slow. Right here, now.
I can tell you every single thing you have in your pockets.
You have X-ray vision, dude? I don't even know what's in my pockets. Let me see. Okay, Max. Impress me.
I don't know.
Do you have some kind of power or not? Okay, psychic girl. Let me show you what's actually in my pockets. That was beyond epic fail. You even made me want to believe you.
Okay, Max. Study every item carefully and don't forget anything. This is me telling you what's inside your pockets.
Okay, Max. I'm hella ready.
I'm pretty sure you have cigarettes on you.
Yes, you know I'm a smoker. But how many cigarettes?
7 cigarettes.
A superpower that allows you to count cigarettes. Cool. Amazing. Something else in my pockets?
Your car keys.
Duh, way too easy. I need details. Describe my keychain.
A cute robot panda keychain.
Not bad, Super Max. You do have that Irish luck, Caulfield. What else?
Some money.
Clearly I'm rich as fuck. How much do I have?
86 cents.
That's right, living large in Arcadia Bay. So that was cool. Show me more.
A parking ticket.
You know me well. But what is the exact time I was busted?
10:34 a.m.
Booyah! Max can tell time! Amazeballs! I literally just got chills all over my neck! You have powers!
I'll take that crap off the table, Chloe.
Sure, Mom.
How's the food, Max?
Better than I remembered.
Very good save.
Man, I'm hungry like the wolf.
Clearly.
I'm freaking out about what just happened. You have to show me more. Something way cooler so I will believe you without any doubt.
I will predict the future.
No way.
Now, pay attention to everything that happens in the next few moments, so you can dazzle Chloe with your mad power.
Oops.
Did you break another cup? Really? No refill for you.
Shh. Now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
You're a dick.
Don't slap me, bitch. Take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
Sure the hell better than that other garbage.
I think our jukebox is headed for Davy Jones's locker.
So, what are you waiting for?
I'm going to predict 4 events that will happen in the next 30 seconds or so. The trucker drops his mug and Joyce rips him a new one.
So, what happens next?
The cop gets an emergency alert on his radio, and his partner in the car leaves without him.
Well, let's just see how this goes down.
Justin and Trevor are fighting, and Joyce breaks it up.
This is getting good! Can't wait to see what happens!
The jukebox goes crazy as a cockroach crawls on it.
Pretty bizarro, Max. But let's see if everything happens like you said.
Oops!
Did you break another cup?
Oh,
really?
Go, Mom.
No refill for you.
Shh! Now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
You called it. But he's off to go bust some skaters.
You're a dick.
Don't slap me, bitch. Take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
Trevor and Justin must be in love. You predicted a cockroach on the jukebox? I pledge allegiance to Max and the power for which she stands.
This isn't a toy, Chloe. I do have to be careful how I use it.
Screw that! Of course it's a toy. The best toy ever? You can bang anyone with no strings attached, rewind time, and boom! It's like it never happened!
Grow up.
Maybe you made a move on me and I would never know.
Yes, that's what I did.
You can rewind time, Max. That's fucking insane. We have to play.
I don't have time.
You did not just say that. check out your nose. Too much blow? Hey, are you okay?
Too much excitement. See what happens when we hook up again?
Then, let's go to one of my secret lairs and fully test your power. You need a sidekick to guide you.
Okay, Girl Wonder. Show me the way to Chloe's cave. Chloe finally believes me. And I wonder what kind of crazy shit she has in mind now.
Okay, Supergirl, let's go to my secret place. Don't even answer. We have places to go and people to do. Come on, before Mom starts some more shit, let's bail.
It's Kate Marsh from Blackwell.
Big whoop. You don't call me once in 5 years and now you're all over some biatch you see every day at school? I see how you roll. So go ahead, chat up Kate Marsh from Blackwell. I've got other people to hang out with too.
Hey, Kate. What's up?
Please, don't let your best friend get in the way.
You okay? I promise, Kate. I won't forget. I swear. Just do your homework and don't stress. I really don't think we should go into this right now. I'll call you later, okay?
Thanks, Max. If you'd rather chill with Kate, please, go ahead.
You are ridiculous. I'm chilling with you, okay?
For now. Let's rock.
Sucks that Chloe and Joyce got into an argument. I could rewind and not answer Kate. It's not like I won't see her in class later. Pissed at me this week.
That depends on you and how well you do in this phase of the test. Welcome to American Rust, my home away from hell.
Raw and rough. It suits you.
Max, do you know how awesome this is? I get my best friend back and she's also supersized.
We don't know for how long.
Exactly why it's time to have fun.
David might be a douche, but you did steal his gun. Is everybody armed in Arcadia Bay now?
Only the ones who shouldn't be, like Step Dildo. Until now.
I'm not in the revolution yet, Che.
You are the revolution, Max. So we should figure out how to best use and abuse your power with a test. Drink?
Yuck.
You are so cute. You haven't changed a bit. Okay, let's do this. Can you find 5 bottles while I prep the shooting range?
Beer and guns? Nice combo.
You can handle it. Now go find us 5 bottles, pretty please.
Every car has its own tale and history. Aw, poor thing. They left you here all alone. All this rusted metal makes me feel serene. Am I morbid or just goth? This looks like a graffiti museum for Chloe and Rachel. I bet I can find out more about Rachel here. That kind of hurts. Now, what's up with this weird secret relationship? Sounds like Rachel was confused about it, maybe even ashamed. I wish she named names. I better not show this to Chloe or she will be seriously hurt. They really were besties. That could have been me instead of Rachel. Hello, bottle number one. Four more to go. Ouch. I want to die. Jeez. Who wrote this? So Rachel did go to a Vortex Club party. This flyer is dated right before she disappeared. I don't want to intrude, but I was here. Now we're officially a trio. We just have to find Rachel. I can't see Chloe playing with makeup. Rachel songs. I wonder if Chloe would ever make me a mixtape. Thanks for the tip. Boom, only three bottles left.
Oh, seriously? I hate when I rewind just a little too far.
Now, I could use this board as a bridge. Doesn't look too heavy. I bet I could get on the boat from a higher location. So disturbing to see old syringes on the ground.
I just wonder if that's a nod to episode 4, or if that's just coincidence. Gun shells, too.
Those shells look fresh. The Bigfoots were here. I could use this board as a bridge. Doesn't look too heavy.
Okay, yeah, but why can't I lift it? Oh my god. Come on. You never gave me this much trouble the first time around.
I bet I could get on the boat from a higher location.
Yes. There we go.
Way heavier than I thought. Ugh. Three down, two more. Go. Talk about finding a bottle in a haystack. It's hard to believe that was once on the road, filled with dozens of students.
Excuse me.
One more bottle to go. Beyond repair. Rest in peace. This is the scariest thing here. I wonder how many generations of fashion went through that washing machine. Exactly like the same dough from my tornado vision.
Oh, it is in the spot. Oh.
That dough is the perfect photo op.
Oh.
This was an old school puncture. Somebody could have left bottles on some of these junker cars. It's hard to believe that was once on the road. Filled with dozens of students.
Voila. Now I can deliver this bottle booty to Captain Chloe.
Thanks, Max. Wait, one more for the road.
You're serious about this?
We're gonna shoot all these bottles without wasting a single bullet. Max, you have to help me aim. Show me the way, Max.
I need to see you shoot first.
Show me the way, Max.
Aim a bit to the right.
Sir, yes, sir. Oh, yes! Did you see that shit, Max?
Duh.
That was so fucking cool! Now for the second bottle. Now, Max, where do I aim?
You're on target. Pull the trigger.
Now, Max, where do I aim?
Aim slightly above.
Right between the eyes. Watch out, Nathan. Now that is fun. Let's pump up the volume and find me another target. I want to get creative here. Give me something to shoot, Max. Hello, what should I shoot?
Let's take out this wheel rim on your left.
Taking out the wheel rim now? Hella yes!
Nice shooting, Tech.
Now that's what I'm talking about.
Satisfied?
Like, never. So I want one more uber cool trick shot.
How about using that junker for a target now? How about aiming for the left tire?
Adios, spinning wheel of death. Uber cool. I cannot believe this is for reals. My best friend is a superhero. Now it's your turn to bust a cap.
I don't know.
Max, your nose. Damn.
I don't feel so super.
Max! You freaked me out there. Do you feel any better now?
A little. Thanks for helping me. Just give me a minute.
Too much action for Arcadia?
Maybe not enough. This is kind of fun. Scary and stupid, but fun.
Let me know when you feel okay.
God, this power really messes with my head. Glad I feel normal again. I better go chat up Chloe. Look at her. Chloe can even chill out playing with a gun.
Okay. Looks like you're ready to lock and load.
I don't know about this.
Are you afraid of getting in trouble? Oh, boo-hoo. Max is afraid. I know you can handle this. And I'm here to guide you. Make me proud, sister.
Hey, it's Thelma and Louise. Or is it Bonnie and Clyde?
Excuse us, Frank.
Oh, sorry, Chloe. Don't let me get in the way of your bonding. I heard the gunshots and the breaking glass. It's cute that you're playing with guns. Just like me at your age.
We're not anything alike, man.
We both need money. In fact, you need it so bad, you owe me a shitload, don't you, Chloe? Huh?
You'll get your money.
Don't they all say that? You know, even when they're broke and acting tough? What are you hiding there, girlie? Let me see.
Where did you get that bracelet?
A friend, and it's none of your goddamn business. You're my business now.
That's Rachel's bracelet. Why the fuck are you wearing her bracelet?
Calm yourself, all right? It was a gift.
No, it wasn't. You stole that shit. Give it to me right now, asshole.
You better step back before you regret it, girl. I mean it. You want me to cut you, bitch?
Please. Please step back.
You're kidding. Put that down. Come on, girlie. Shoot me. Ah, Christ. You're more like Abbott and Costello. Nice piece. I'll consider this interest on your loan. Thanks. You have until Friday to pay me, or I'll track you down with this interest. Have a good play, kids.
You really stood your ground.
I freaked. I don't like guns.
It'll be hard to keep Nathan off my ass. My step shit will have his other gun sealed in an electrified bunker by now.
Sorry, Chloe. I've never held a gun on a human being before. Not cool.
I know, Max. Really. I'm actually relieved it worked out this way instead. And there are more guns out there. Let's blow. My secret lair didn't feel secret today. At least Frank is gone. He won't fuck with us again. He just wants his money.
Oh, man. Frank took Chloe's gun because of me. Wowzer. Why did Frank have Rachel's bracelet? We need to talk about this later, but I better follow Chloe now. I wonder if Chloe thinks about her father when she looks at all these smashed up cars. Chloe's waiting to go for a walk. We both need a time.
I can't believe you basically gave him my gun. Here you go, Frank.
You can't keep getting mad at me. Especially for stupid shit.
I'm not mad. It adds up in my mind as people letting me down. And I just liked having that gun, man.
Now you have me to protect you.
I'm just glad you were here.
Me too. I think. Chloe, why the hell are you hanging around scary losers like Frank? It's weird.
Let's take a break and I'll talk. Feels like a different world, huh? I wish we could stay forever.
Can we build another pirate fort and keep the world out?
We need a new secret hangout. At least Frank wouldn't find us. Are you okay, Max?
I'm still freaked out about what happened. That was awful, Chloe.
I'm sorry. But Frank isn't as hardcore as he fronts. All he cares about is his cash, stash, and mangy dog.
Chloe, are you for reals? Frank just took your gun and threatened us. He's armed and clearly dangerous.
Max, I know. Crazy shit is the new normal for me. That's why I plan to leave Arcadia Bay without paying Frank off.
Now, tell me exactly what's going on between you and Frank. Does he have a last name?
Frank Bowers. Obviously don't get my pot from you, remember? Anyway, Frank and I kind of hung out.
Hung out? You don't mean you... Ah, no, we didn't have sex. Gross, man. He never even tried.
I just made the mistake of borrowing money so Rachel and I could bail out of here.
That's it?
No. I want to know how Frank got Rachel's bracelet. What do you think?
I don't know anymore. My brain is so fried from all of this. I need a mental enema.
It's so weird talking to you about this insane crap. We haven't hung out this much since we were tweens, and it's like no time has passed. I wish Rachel was here to meet you.
Do you think that Rachel and I would have been friends?
You're not that different. She had... has a great eye for images and for art. Plus, she's a smartass like you. We would all be hella best friends forever.
I know she must be as cool as you are. I have no doubt we'll meet soon.
Railroad tracks always make me feel better. I have no idea why.
Kerouac knew. It's the romance of travel and movement. The sound of the train whistle at night.
Look at the beat poet here.
I'd rather be a good photographer.
You are. You just have to stop being afraid.
Perfect. The drum.
Come on, Max! Hurry!
This wedge locks the drum in place. Shit, I can't budge it at all. I can definitely use this bad boy. Okay, what can I slice with this?
Max,
in and out, no problem.
Max.
Awesome, it's not locked.
The train's coming! Max,
maybe an axe isn't the best precision tool for electronics. Crowbar? For real? I can't even move it an inch.
Max, please! The train's coming! Max, please!
This wedge locks the drum in place. I can finally move the drum.
Damn it.
help lift Chloe up.
Damn. That was close.
You saved me again. Crazy. We were totally bombed in life.
You okay?
I got splinters in my ass and leg, so I wish there was a less violent way for you to save me. And now the trains can't get to the lumber mill. Oops. Aren't you glad I took you away to a nice, quiet, desolate spot?
It was cool to spend time in your lair, but I have to get back to school before my next class.
Since you're the mysterious superhero, I'll be your faithful chauffeur and companion.
My powers might not last, Chloe.
That's okay. We will. Forever.
Thanks for the ride, Chloe. Right on time for my art lesson.
Thanks for coming with me. Sorry to be so boring.
Nothing exciting ever happens to us, right?
Listen, your rewind power has to be connected to that snow yesterday. That might explain your tornado vision.
Explain what? Snow equals a ginormous twister that takes out Arcadia Bay? You're high.
Wake up, Max. You saved my life twice now. You altered the course of my destiny, yours, and whoever. Do you know about chaos theory?
It means shit happens, right?
No, crazy shit happens. Because it can. And will.
Why me? I'm just a geek girl in some small town.
A perfect example of strange attractors? Don't they teach you kids anything at Blackwell? We have a tornado, rewind power, and freak snow. Hello, Armageddon. So let's party with your power, Rockstar!
Like he said, Professor Price, a superhero needs a sidekick.
How can it be such a shitty week and yet one of the best of my life?
Because we're back in action again. I have a little time before Mr. Jefferson's class, so I can do some wandering.
So are you going to that vortex club?
Hey, Courtney. Ciao, Max. No photos, please. I have to come up with a guest list for a vortex club soiree.
Really?
Oh, like you care. I'm not anti-soiree. You seem anti-fashion, though. A Vortex Club party has a strict dress code. Do you even have a dress? Sorry, but nice try. Hey, Courtney. Ciao.
Really?
Oh. I'm sure the Vortex Club has a dress code. As you can see, I would need your advice on what to wear. Thanks, Max. I didn't think you noticed high fashion. Tell you what. I'll put you down on the guest list, and before the party, I can give you some tips. Cool. Thanks, Courtney. I'll send you the party info later. Back to the list.
That snow was so insane. Seriously. Hello,
Max, can we talk? Do you mind if we talk about what happened yesterday with Chloe?
You hit Chloe.
I'm sure she told you why. Did she mention she probably stole one of my guns?
You're a combat veteran. She's no threat to you.
If I didn't care about her, I wouldn't care at all. When I was her age, I was out raising a lot more hell. She's better than that. All you kids are. So is Kate Marsh.
What about Kate?
You stepped between us at a pretty bad time. She's another matter entirely.
Kate hasn't done anything wrong.
Max, this isn't just about Kate Marsh. My concern is for the safety of all Blackwell students, including you.
That'll take more than surveillance cameras.
It will take more than Ms. Grant and her petition to find missing students.
Isn't that your responsibility as head of security? Unless you know something about Rachel Amber that nobody else does.
I don't want to fight with you anymore. I don't want to fight with anyone anymore. That's all, Max.
I still have time. I could go see Warren playing mad scientist in the lab.
That's me. I had to score some weed from Nathan. Think, big brain, think.
Bring me the brain, Igor. Hey, Warren. Are you okay? You look thoughtful yet confused.
Maxwell Silverhammer. Perfect timing. I need help with this chemical experiment.
Asking me for help means you're screwed.
I have to add either a bit of potassium or sodium. It's up to you to decide, Dr. Max.
I'm not sure why you're letting me decide your fate, but go potassium.
Potassium it shall be. If this works, you get a free hug. Weird science. This can't-
Hey, Warren. I actually think you should use a lot of potassium. I mean, a shitload.
See? Look at that smile. You're going to become a scientist yet. Let's do this thing. She blinded me with science.
I bet if I touch the glass, all these creepy sea critters will pop up. Or nothing will happen at all.
Understand my position.
What?
I want you to be honest.
Nobody believes me anyway.
Stop acting so brittle.
Being on a viral video does that.
Maybe this is your way of getting attention.
That's really mean, Mr. Jefferson. You just don't get it. Just leave me alone.
You have to talk to me, Kate.
Why? It's all over, like me.
Knock off this martyr crap.
What do you want from me?
I want you to be honest.
Nobody, so you can't help me?
I'm trying, but you have to understand my position.
Why? You don't understand mine.
Sorry to bother you, Mr. Jefferson.
I'm only bothered when you avoid turning in photos, but you know this. So what can I do for you, Max?
Just between you and me, I'm worried about Kate Marsh.
That's no secret. Word on the street is that you and Kate had a little confrontation with our security chief yesterday.
I stepped in between David Madsen barking all up in Kate's face about something. She doesn't deserve that.
Of course not. Mr. Madsen isn't the most gentle soul. Do you have proof he instigated the situation?
My word isn't good enough? The one time I choose not to take a picture.
Always take the shot. My number one rule of photography. And Max, I promise this matter is being discussed by the faculty. I assume you know about this viral video?
Kate is freaked out by all of this. She can't do homework while she's being tormented on a daily basis.
What if Kate brought this on herself? She means well, but maybe she doth protest too much. She seems like she's holding back the truth. Have you talked to her?
Yes, I talked to her on the phone today. She needs friends and support now. I just don't want Kate Marsh to become the next Rachel Amber.
Rachel Amber? What does she have to do with Kate?
With all her missing persons posters around, it's hard not to think of her.
Rachel was nothing like Kate. And Principal Wells said you had something on your mind you wouldn't tell him. You care to share?
Not right now. I'll tell you everything as soon as I figure it out.
I'd like to believe that, Max. It just seems like there's a lot of drama around you this week.
Listen, should I...
Excuse me, Max. Hello? Yes? Hold on. I have to take this, so just go into class and I'll be there soon.
Shady. I really want to know who he's talking to here.
Sure, okay. Listen, I do have a class I have to teach. I have to go. Okay, I'll do that. Oh, I know. That makes sense. Seriously, I have to hang up now. Let's talk about this later. We'll talk later, okay? I have to go. Because I can't have this conversation with you right now, okay? Would you please just hang up the phone?
Stella is smart to stay out of all the drama.
Bo.
Dana, you are out of control. Turn left, then right. Show me
what's
the
up,
love.
Daniel?
Waiting to draw Dana after Hayden gets his paparazzi on. I hope you like the sketch I did of you yesterday.
Love. And it's my new avatar.
Excellent. I got tons of likes on FB. Ah, made you blush.
Shut up.
Someday, your portrait may hang in the Daniel de Costa wing of the Louvre. We'll talk about it later.
That's a great sketch of Dana. Daniel is the real deal.
Not now, Max. I'm contemplating shit.
Do you think Max will be pissed we're sitting at her desk?
Oh, I'm sure she'll report us to the principal. Like I give a flying fuck.
Or she'll run to Mr. Jefferson, like he gives a shit.
Like anybody does. Max is such a little... Here comes the mysterious Max. Disguised as a pixie hipster.
Like all the other precious twee artists here.
You really nailed me.
Meow! Bring out the claws. I love seeing chicks fight.
Right. Can I sit at my table now?
Max thought we were going to be buds. Fucking ha ha.
Assholes. Okay, why is David taking photos of Kate? Now this is so wrong and weird.
What up, Max?
Hey, Warren.
I saw Kate earlier and her eyes were puffy from crying.
K- Kate has a lot on her plate.
I didn't know what to say, and she didn't tell me anything.
Okay, I know you love me, but if you're not in this class, beat it. Everybody else, please sit down. We have a lot to cover today, and so little time as usual. I see all the usual suspects here. Anybody seen Kate Marsh?
I think everybody has seen Kate Marsh by now.
She's not feeling good.
Sounds like you're giggling about a video gone viral. Maybe it involves a student or a friend. I wonder how it would feel to have false images of yourself shot out all over the world for people to judge. Usually, people need something to judge so they never take a good look at themselves. We can thank reality TV for some of that. In the end, we can only blame ourselves for participating. Speaking of participation, there are a few souls here who have yet to enter a photo in the contest. Like Max Caulfield, for example, who I know can't wait to enter, right? I'm sure you read the syllabus like it was a Harry Potter book, so you must know today we're studying chiaroscuro. That beautiful word about the contrast between light and dark. The
shadow. I guess Kate will miss class now. Visual power. I'm worried about her.
Basic yin and yang. Black and white images are effective precisely because of their contrast. Although we don't technically see in mind.
Yo! Some crazy shit is going down in the girls' dorm!
Zachary, do not come into my class like that ever again. Listen! Everybody remain seated. Dismissed.
Is this for real?
It slipped out!
I didn't think she was that messed up.
She can't die. She can't. Not again. Not now. I have to try something. I won't be able to rewind again and again.
What are you doing here, Max? Stop! Don't come near me!
Not now. It won't work. I don't have any power. Now I have to do this by myself?
Max, seriously, don't come near me. I will jump.
Okay, okay. I'm right here. Kate, please.
Oh, Max, I know you want to help me. I love that you stepped up to David, but it doesn't matter now. Nothing matters.
You matter, and not just to me.
I do want to believe that.
Kate, your life is still yours, and we can get through this together. Let me help, like I helped by erasing all that crap people wrote on your room slate.
I'm glad to hear you worry about me. That makes me feel better.
Of course I worry. You're my friend, Kate.
I did feel better talking to you on the phone. feel like you really listen. Kate, please trust me. Come stand by me, okay? I can help you now. I know I can. This morning, I erased the web link to the video. It was written on the shower room mirror.
That's your story now. How can I trust you? What about this morning when I needed help? You told me to do nothing.
Kate, I'm gathering proof that Nathan Prescott drugged you. And you're not the only victim. So you have to help me take Nathan down.
Nathan Prescott? That makes sense. He's a scumbag. You have proof now?
Soon, then straight to the police. Think of it like we're cleansing Blackwell.
You do have my back, Max. That's the first time I've felt hopeful in a week.
Good. We all need to have each other's backs. So I want you to come with me now. Please, you don't have to do this.
Max, I'm in a nightmare and I can't wake up. Unless I put myself to sleep. Then everybody at Blackwell can post pics of my body. Morty on the internet forever. No wonder they call it a web. Nothing can ever get out. Like my video. I wish I could go back in time and erase everything.
Kate, this is our chance to beat the bullies. That's the only way we can win against them.
Can we really, Max? I don't believe in miracles anymore either.
Now I do. You're part of the reason why. If you come down with me, I can tell you more.
You're such a good person, Max. Even if you're full of crap. But I'll come with you. You're my friend.
Forever. Can we hug on it?
No. Nobody cares about me. Nobody.
I saw that cute photo of you with your sisters in your room this morning. I can see how much your little sister loves you by her smile.
That's Lynn. She's only 10. She does have the best smile ever. I would hate to see her sad. I'm sorry. Sorry.
What are you talking about? You saved me from talking in class.
Now, I know today was difficult for everybody, but I'm so proud of the way Blackwell pulled together to save a young girl's life. Of course, you're quite a hero for getting Kate to come down, Max.
I didn't do much.
She's modest. Like a real hero.
Yeah, real hero.
As principal of Blackwell Academy, I take my duties seriously. I take the well-being of every student more seriously. What happened today should never happen in a hall of wisdom and knowledge. Mr. Madsen. As our head of security here, those roof doors should always be locked. That's just standard operating procedure. They were not, and that is indeed your responsibility. Mr. Jefferson, I know you can't be expected to know what your students are going through, but Kate has assisted you in class, so you should have known something was amiss. Mr. Prescott, since you are responsible for the Vortex Club parties, and since Miss Marsh did attend your last party, you'll have to answer some more questions. Miss Caulfield, why exactly were you on the roof with Kate Marsh? Did she tell you her plan? Or anything at all? Please, tell us everything.
I saw Mr. Jefferson talking to Kate right before our class. Then she ran off crying.
Mark, I do know that Miss Marsh has assisted you on class events.
Kate, Miss Marsh has been very withdrawn lately. I assume this awful video was the cause. I hated seeing the students laugh at her. She was upset Miss Caulfield didn't return her calls. She felt rejected by the school.
She shouldn't have asked to be on video, macking with some dudes.
You ass! She didn't
ask for any of this.
No, on the contrary. Max was right to bring this up. Now, I wanted to help, but I guess I was too late.
Well, now this is problematic. The publicity is rising, and perhaps you shouldn't represent Blackwell at the Everyday Heroes contest in San Francisco.
Are you serious?
I am. We don't need any negative press about that event. And we need to involve the Academy in possible disciplinary measures for you.
I understand. There are bigger things at stake than me. The life of a young girl, for one. Maybe you should investigate other staff members. Max told me she knew things about Mr. Madsen.
Let Max speak for herself. Everything we talked about here will be looked into. All right, Miss Caulfield, please sign here to confirm what you've told us. I'll continue this investigation from there.
My head is killing me, but I think I can use my power again.
Nope, I'm sticking with it.
Well, I think we know less now than when we started. We'll be assisting the police with further inquiries. I know this has been a stressful day. I wish I had the power to change it all for the better. So thank you for coming in.
That's gonna affect episode 5 if it does at all.
I couldn't even believe it was happening. It was literally slow motion as I grabbed her hand. And then I could feel her grabbing mine.
Max, that was the greatest thing I've ever seen. Ever! You reached out, she reached out, hugs, tears, applause. Like a superhero.
Not quite. Look at me. I'm a mess.
You're glowing. Seriously, a human halo. I'm pretty sure you earned your wings today.
I'm still worried about Kate. She did try to kill herself. All over a video.
Viral is the right word. Like a disease.
So you watched it?
Just 1.5 times.
Warren, I don't mean to sound weird, but there's something ominous going on at Blackwell.
Today proves that.
And I'm working on proof that Kate Marsh is connected to Rachel Amber. Somehow. Along with Nathan and Mr. Madsen.
I'm not a big conspiracy guy, but I wouldn't doubt it. Nathan did scare me yesterday, and Madsen is a straight-up dickhead. So, what do you think is really happening?
What the hell is this? The weather confirms this weird day. I feel that chill.
Max, there was no eclipse scheduled today. I would know. I would.
I believe you, Warren.
Yeah, it's getting there. I'm not sure how much you missed.
I believe anything this week.
Probably gonna upload them soon. I did blame Jefferson this time.
You.
All right, and that was episode 2.